went right. Instead of left out of the closing bar. And at East 7th and C, walk smack into a standoff. Between neighborhood grunts and wife beaters and jeans. Holding bats and chains. And turning, one says, what the fuck? And another, higher voice says, yeah, what the fuck, white boy? And white boy says, oh, fuck. Then goes, give up the chase. And fall back as the summer rain comes down heavier and heavier. And drenched on a corner somewhere. Unable to light the smoke. Dangling a quiver in its lips. A cop car cruises by and slows to this wet, panting figure in a doorway. Failing to light match after match. And laughing, one of them says, how's your night, Chief? After you, by name in the quiet garden. Forestalling eventualities to have one more look at you. Knowing you're less a presence than an urge to be moving on. Walking fast, a simulated act of contempt. A leap away. And what a leap. Last night's clothes pressed in the body. Thank you. bastard at that. But in a quiet garden, under a too bright sun, contempt is just an overbearing lack of the right words. Wincing asserts a shy, yet firm departure. Despite yourself, the weather offers its cue for a walk and leads you among mothers walking babies, among parts of a small dusty town more than the sum of its heat and its primroses, to a valedictory itch in the loins, overslept. There's an unexpected grace in moving on, in those words, to be. They're rarely ever used for any other reason than to take up a role, to be somehow above all the insouciance of manhood, but acquire what? That leap. Fucked each other and dried out in the light of day. You must get into the car. Ride. And wait for the moment you forget what day it is. What you did not say. In the lamplight's newborn rite of petition. Okay, yes, I fucked around. Or even the tears all over the rug that forced acquittal. He lied willingly, a lot. The heart soaring, not listening. Case. their sleeping battles, and the beautiful evil confessions that come seeping out of you, like the scent of dust from the bed. He goes over them all, calibrating names of cities, dates, places, the whole rotational flux of images, true or not really. And they'll just lay still in the dark, each of them, information him, her, knowing the other's awake. Oh, we're shaking for more. It was actually some uptown building's peak light, appearing at a glance out the train window, just as round and propped in that occurring hyper-real clarity, low in the sky. Surprise alone was striking enough to jot down in a rumpled matchbook. The only thing I had to bear witness and to extend your amusement. Until some seconds passed, and you tapped me, saying, like that, pointing behind us. Over there. Look. Climbing up the backs of skyscrapers, and still so yellow. Not yet rinsed of the horizon. Just as the west is melting behind Jersey. Thank you. again, only deeper this time. All those desolate evenings and erratic early morning, waiting on phone calls, continents apart, staring out of windows and up at moons, like we were banished from every reckoning critical to time and place. Asterisks in a story of fugues. Or like we were lofted to, and we're only now coming down through winds and meridians into the solid presence of this train, into these seats, the passengers around us, the shitty but welcome light, everything taken captive for our new eyes' sudden appraisal, our own keeping. anonymous but inviting vibes. And comes perched, despite her critical stores of boredom. One frail shift and that brittle perch comes undone. Collapsing one blink at a time into the low, opiated rumble since departed from her ears. What she really snapped to? Shit. Suddenly mindful of the fresh nail polish she daintily avoids smudging. Despite her burning her cigarette, and mother's mothering call. She could be rising again, padding barefoot into her room. Shutting the door, just like that. To him, to whom turning that strange, strange blue. Could be rising again, padding barefoot into a room like that, shutting the door just like that, to him. To him turning that strange blue.
We were told the bubbles should look like little pebbles you could pour clean into your hand. Go on, shake it. said Pina. Junk dealer, mechanic, and feral cat wrangler by day. Shiner by night. Shake her up, pour some in the cap. We shook our samples, twisted off the caps, and poured. Atop a float of clear liquid, rolling over each other, fighting their way to the surface. Now, he said, dropping his voice to a firm yet reverential whisper, "That there, boys, is good shit." It hit us like a vow, and then became one. And we each bought one of the plastic reused Mountain Dew bottles for a couple of months, and took them back home, and drank them slowly that night. Feeling the good, tingly shit roll down the lengths of our throats and simmer in our guts. So that each passing sip became a deeper nucleus of lush darkness. Wetting some soft, acidified manner we could never lay claim to, nor hope to abandon in another dark, balmy night years later, when Peanut's drunken, loose-limbed body plunged end over end from the water tower. Reclaimed by the backwoods of northern Florida. Darkness batting from the gaps of forest trees. And above us, clouds like great, great brains. By nightfall, Louisville is blacked out and reduced to crucible quick chatter in candlelit bars and other spotty garrets of light. Way up the road, vanishing points.
Nothing in over 500 miles with sky but rippling aerial geographies licked by wind and rain. Hold strung links of torch pearl. And it's been dark and it's so long. Oh, it's been madness from the evening pearl crests of the Shenandoah peaks to this barren town, waylaid in the final morning stars. Mobs of sparrows are breaking through.
Magnetic way up and up and up along a nameless vector. Rhythms, pithy tendrils, calm and warm too. Till a familiar caress loops. Dipping down sinuous anchors like falling stars. To feed this gently tricky surge, more astral flux. Thank you. And here things turn spooky. More white hallways hatches open up, accreting and voracious. And through every hatch she plummets down, spiraling an ape face. Accorded its place as defined target. So the target may take its muted blows into Godhead.